a long time. We won't go into those details. And he goes every morning to the Matatu stage, from 6 p.m. to 7 a.m. and prays for them. So that day, and he's 87, how many years? 86 years. We shall have fellowship again. He goes there even now. This, we can't go without glorifying God for that. And then we have the ushers here. They just gave up their life to serve here as ushers in this church. Just give glory to God, and then you'll give the children. You will.
The elders have people to pass the baton to. Praise the name of the Lord. And it's also a challenge. When the elders are serving the Lord, it is a challenge to us who have strength. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So let's just give God the glory because of them. And I believe that there's going to be an impartation. The Lord is going to give you more grace. Despite your age, the Lord is going to give you more grace. The Bible says that Moses was the age of 120. His eyes were not dim, and his strength was not abated. So, in your age, the Lord will continue to renew your youth as you serve him. Hallelujah. Let's all stand on our feet as we pray.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise and we give you honor. We thank you because when you call, we always say that we will answer. Thank you for calling this dear brethren in your service, dear Father. And we thank you because of the faithfulness that they have been serving you with, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for those that you have given the ministry of evangelism, oh Lord. It is a challenge that this elder, dear Father, even today, he goes and speaks your gospel in the bus stations, dear Father. We pray that you're going to give him more grace and more favor in the name of Jesus. As he continues to serve you, dear Father, may you continue to renew his strength, dear Lord. We thank you even because of Mom Alice, dear Father. We declare new strength, dear Father, even in this land that she has come, oh God. You are the one who gives us grace, dear Father, to adapt and to serve in the new territory, oh God. I declare grace upon her in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the ministry of ushers, oh God. I commit them at your able hands, dear Father, as they serve in your house, oh God, as they enjoy the joy of the Lord to be their strength, oh God.
Yes.
I declare that they shall become imparters of your grace to the people, dear Father, as they welcome people in the service, King of all glory. Whoever they greet shall receive a blessing because they are blessed in Jesus' name. We thank you, O King of all glory, because your word says that whoever serves you, the Father will honor him. Oh God, I pray that the honor of servants shall be their portion in the name of Jesus, for the glory and honor of your name. We thank you for this dear young ones, Lord. Thank you because of giving us children, Lord, and also for giving us the grace and the courage to bring them into your house, dear Father. We continually dedicate them at your able hands, oh Lord. We continually declare that this generation is sealed by the blood of Jesus. They shall not be lost to that world in Jesus' name, but they shall stand to declare and to show forth your greatness, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for the children ministry, dear Lord.
Yes.
Even as we remember many that are out there, oh God.
Yes.
You say that the kingdom of God, it belongs to those that are humble like children, oh God.
Yes.
We declare that many shall come to you.
Yes.
Just like Jesus, you say that let children come to me.
Yes.
We declare that many children shall come to you, dear Father, for the glory and honor of your name. We bless them in your presence, and we give you praise and honor. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Yes, you are the Lord Most High. Yes, you are the Lord Most High. Yes, you are the Lord Most High. Yes, you are. Yes, you are the Lord.
Yes, you are the Lord, Most High.
the Lord Most High. You are highly exalted above all, O God. You are highly exalted in our hearts, O Lord. You are highly exalted in this place, dear Father. And our hearts are expectant to hear from you, Lord. Because you are the Most High God. 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 And there is none like you, Jehovah. There is none like you, King of all glory. You alone is worthy, Lord. You alone is worthy, Lord. You alone is worthy. You alone is worthy, King of all glory. We thank you for your presence in our midst, O God. We honor you for what you're about to do in our lives this moment, Lord. Our hearts are expecting from you, Jesus. We surrender. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. We may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Just say hi to your neighbor for me. Tell him or her you are highly favored. Amen. Yeah, you are highly favored. Yeah? Amen. It's a great honor to be back again in this place. I don't take it for granted. I don't take it in vain, because I believe that every time the Lord sends someone, there is a purpose. Praise the name of the Lord. And one thing I've taught myself over the years that I've been serving the Lord is that the Lord values His people so much. He values you so much that He can send somebody from miles and miles away just for you. Amen. Not for a crowd, but just for you. Amen. Because you're valuable in the eyes of the Lord. Amen. I always think about the story of the man who was living in the tombs. That man, he used to be tied with chains, but the demons in him were so many that he could not live anywhere else but with the dead. But the Bible says that when Jesus went and met that man, the demons in him asked Jesus, can allow us to go into the pigs? And the pigs were the economy of that city. 2,000 pigs. That is a lot of money. But Jesus did not put the value of that soul and compare it with the value of the pigs. So he decided, I better lose the whole economy of a city and save one soul. Amen. So your life is very much important. And as I speak the word of the Lord today, I want you to know that you are important. You are valuable in the eyes of the Lord. Amen. God cannot change anything with you because you are special. Sometimes we forget that, but it's good to know that we are special. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. It is because of me that Jesus went on the cross. Amen. It is because of you that Jesus went on the cross. Amen. He left all the world up in heaven. I hear in heaven there are rods of gold. He did not care about the gold. He came and died on the cross just because of me, just because of you. Because you're special in the eyes of the Lord. And as I speak today, I want you to first know your value in the eyes of the Lord. Your value is more than gold. Your value is more than precious stones. Your value is more than diamonds. Whatever you think is valuable, know that you're more valuable than that in the eyes of God. And that is why He has given you the breath of life today. That is why He has brought you in His house today. It doesn't matter how many we are, but I believe that the Lord is here because of you. Amen. So as I speak the word today, don't think of so and so did not come. This is not about those who did not come. This is about you. Because today I want to speak about divine positioning. Tell your neighbor, divine positioning. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because we talk of the promises of God, talk of dreams and visions. We talk of the things that God said over our lives. We talk of things we aspire to be or things we aspire to get. Praise the name of the Lord. But in every promise, you need to be at the right position, at the right place for it to come to pass. Praise the name of the Lord. And as we speak about divine positioning at a personal level, I believe that the Lord is also going to position the church at the right place in this season, in the latter days, to manifest the power of God. And you are the church. I am the church. Because the Bible says that the times of the Lord living in temples made by the hands of men are over. He now lives in our hearts. And last time I was here, I talked about the indwelling presence of the Lord, walking in the presence of the Lord. And I believe you people, you have been walking in the presence of the Lord. And so it is now time to be divinely positioned so that we may fulfill the purposes of God concerning our lives. And from our reading, the story of Joseph, the Bible says that his brothers had gone to feed the flock. And let me just go a little back and start with Joseph. Who is Joseph? Joseph had a nickname. He was called Joseph the Dreamer because he was not just an ordinary kid. He was a kid with destiny. He was a kid with a promise. God had spoken to him in form of dreams. Come on now. I don't know which way God has spoken to you concerning your life, but the life of Joseph, God had spoken to him with dreams. And in the dreams, the interpretation was, you are not just an ordinary person, you shall be great in the land. Your brothers will bow down before you. Your father and mother will bow down before you. And it didn't matter whether Joseph was the second from the last in the family of Jacob, but he had a dream. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I don't know whether you have a dream. I don't know whether you just live because it is morning and it is evening, and then you go to bed and wake up in the morning, and then it's evening, you go to bed and wake up in the morning. I don't know whether you have a dream or you have any promises of God you can stand upon. But this young man had the promises of God over his life. And the Bible says that because of that, his brethren did not love him so much. Your promise will make either friends or enemies. Joseph had a friend who is called his father. His father saw the promise of God in his life. He prepared a coat of many colors for him, and he loved him. But his brethren did not love him. Praise the name of the Lord. Come on now, I don't know whether you have a dream. I don't know whether you have a promise of God over your life. I don't know whether promise has brought friends to you or has brought enemies to you. But the Bible says that Joseph did not just sit back and say, now my brothers hate me, I'm not going to continue dreaming. From where we have read, the Bible says that his father called him and told him, now your brothers have gone to feed the flocks in Shechem. Come now, I send you. He gave him food to take to his brothers. And he told him, go and find out how they are, and then come tell me. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
For every promise, there is provision. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And Joseph went and looked for his brother. The Bible says that he was looking for them in Shechem because initially that is where they had said they are going. But when he went to Shechem, and Shechem was a dry place, he could not find his brethren. And he was there wondering, what is wrong here? I can't find my brothers. I am here. I am tired. It is hot. Should I go home? Should I just say I did not find them? Furthermore, they don't love me anymore. I can go back with this food. But he continued looking for them. And in the midst of the wilderness, the Bible says that a man came and asked him, what are you looking for? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
What are you looking for? And he said, I am looking for my brethren. Have you seen them? And the man told him, yeah, I heard them saying, let us go to Dothan. And the Bible says, and Joseph left Shechem and went to Dothan. Praise the name of the Lord. Am I speaking to people with a promise? Am I speaking to people with a dream? I have come to tell you today that the Lord is going to send somebody. Maybe since when God spoke to you, all you have been doing is moving in circles in Shechem. All you have been doing is moving in circles in the wilderness. But there is going to be sent a man. A man was sent to connect David to the right position. And that is what I came to declare today, that somebody will be sent over your life to come and connect you to the right place. Enough of dryness. Enough of moving like somebody who does not understand what you're doing. Even the people who are seeing you can say that you're doing nothing. Wengine wanauliza nini mbaya na huyu, kazi yake ni kuzunguka tu, because you are in Shechem. But it is time, even for the church, somebody to arise and connect them to their divine position. Praise the name of the Lord. And this man told David, Joseph, no. Your brothers are not here. Stop wandering in the wilderness. I've come to tell you, stop wandering in the wilderness. Stop going around in circles and saying, I have a dream. I am going to become great in the land. My brethren will bow before me. But now all I can see is wilderness, nothing more. And Joseph did not go back. Why did he go back? Because he had a message from the Father. Amen. And he was like, I cannot go back until I fulfill that which I've been sent to do. Amen. How many times have you quit? How many times have you gone back? Because you have come to a position of wilderness in your life. And then you start saying, maybe I was not called. Maybe I'm not supposed to be like that. Maybe it is not me, it is my children. How many people have surrendered even their dreams and said, okay, even if it doesn't happen in my days, it will happen over my children. I have come to tell you, no. It is time for you to be divinely positioned. And let me tell you, the moment that Joseph moved from Shechem and went down to Dothan, that is where he started his journey towards his dreams. Because that is where they put him in the pit. That is where they sold him to the Ishmaelites. That is where he started his journey to Egypt. That is where he started his journey to the land that he shall become a prime minister. Amen. What you need is somebody to connect you. I am calling forth for destiny connectors. People that can tell you it is time to move now. It is time to go to Dothan. Praise the name of the Lord. And you know what the word Dothan means? Dothan means a place of two wells. It is a place of double blessing. It is a place that there is no dryness. It is a place where there is plenty. It is a place where there is supply. And that is why the brethren had gone to feed the flock, because there was enough. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. In the days of Shechem, there is a lot of scarcity. There is a lot of discouragement. There is a lot of dryness. But I have come to declare the time of dwelling in Shechem is over. The time for the church to dwell in Shechem is over. It is time now we move on to Dothan. The time of trying to sing choruses here and people are not even singing. You tell people pray, they look at you. Dryness in the church. You tell people to give, they look at you. You tell people to come for a Bible study, they look at the time. They want to go to work. Seriously? There is so much dryness in the church today.
Amen.
But I am tired of that dryness. I have come to ignite fire in you, that you may also be tired with that dryness and say, enough is enough. It is time now to move from Shechem and go to Dothan, the place of two wells, the place of double blessing, the place of plenty, the place of power, the place of manifestation. And the Bible says in the book of 1 Kings that a time came. The king of Syria was planning evil against the king of Israel. But there was a man. Tell your neighbor, a man. And he was not just a man, but he was a man of God. Yeah, there was a man of God called Elisha. So every time the king king of Syria planned how to attack Israel, the man of God would know what the enemies have planned. And he would go and tell the king of Israel, do not pass that way, do not pass that way, do not pass that way. Until where we have read, the king got angry. He called all his men and said, now you tell me, who is the traitor here? Who is the spy? I need to know. Who among you is for the king of Israel? Why is it that every time we plan to attack him? Why? Praise the name of the Lord. Yeah. And then there was one man among them who told him, let me tell you, it is not that we have a traitor, but in Israel there is a man of God.
Amen.
There is a man of God.
Amen.
This man of God knows everything you say. Even whatever you say in your bedroom, this man of God can hear. And the king of Syria decided, okay, it is time to get this man of God. And he asked, where is this man of God? And they said, behold, he is in Dothan.
Amen.
He is in the place of double blessing. He is in the place of double wealth. He is in the place that is connected with heavens. He can understand the strategies of the enemy. The reason why there's so much defeat, it is because of where we are. Ask your neighbor, where are you? Where are you? Where are you standing? You are there saying, yes, the Lord promised me. But what are you doing? Where are you positioned? Because there is a place you can be positioned and victory will be yours. There is a place you can be positioned and you'll be able to know the strategies of the enemy. There is a place you can be in position and you will get double blessing.
Amen.
The Bible says that in Dothan, this man of God was in Dothan. And when the king of Syria sent the armies to come and capture him, the Bible says that his servant woke up one morning, went outside, and he saw that they are surrounded. And then he came back in and he told the man of God, we are done. We are going to die today. In Dothan, there is no doom. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And the man of God said, you know what? God opened his eyes. Let him see those that are on our side.
Yes.
And when Gehazi's eyes were open, he saw that there was a mighty army that had surrounded with chariots and horses that was greater than the enemy that had surrounded them.
Amen.
And he did not stop there. In Dothan, I said, it's a place of double blessing. It is a place of the double sword. When he said, let his eyes be open, he also said, let the eyes of my enemy be made blind. Tell your neighbor, divine positioning. Where are you going to operate twice? In doubles. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Eyes open, eyes shut. Where you have a way of advancing in your dreams, in the vision, and you have a way of fighting with your enemies and those that pursue you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Behold, he is in Dothan. Ask your neighbor again, where are you?
Where are you?
You are there saying, I cannot go. I cannot do this because they hate me. They talk about me. I cannot serve them anymore. Come on now. It is not about them. It is about you.
Amen.
So many people have sat down. You started serving the Lord. They started talking. And then you say, oh, I better sit down because when I'm doing nothing, nobody talks. Now, that is when the enemy wins.
Uh-huh.
But it is time to be divinely positioned in a place where there is power. In a place where you can say, thus says the Lord. In a place where you can execute what God has commissioned you to do. And a place where you can silence the enemy. A place where you can fight the battles in the godly way.
Amen.
The Bible says in the book of Ephesians that behold, we are seated in the heavenlies with Christ.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
We are seated in the
heavenlies.
Hiya. Tell your neighbor, we are seated in the heavenlies. Hatuko hapa. Sio hapa unatuonea. We are seated in the heavenlies. And what are we doing in the heavenlies? We are reigning together with Christ.
Amen.
When you know that you are positioned with Christ, then you act like Christ would act.
Amen.
You do things like Christ would do. I always ask myself in a situation, what would Jesus do? When you understand your position, no matter the challenges that you're going to face, you're going to stand and do like Jesus would do. Because we are seated in the heavenlies with Christ Jesus. We are reigning. We've got power and dominion. Wacha kukaa kama kuku amenyeshewa. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The season of staying like we are defeated is over.
Amen.
I came to declare it is time for us to be divinely positioned in Dothan. A place of double blessing.
Amen.
A place of double life.
Yes.
I want you to evaluate your life. Where are you? Where are you? Come on, ask your neighbor, where are you? Because when we understand where we are and where we are going and where we want to be, praise the name of the Lord,
amen,
then we are going to be positioned in the right place. I don't know much about cars, but I know there is something called alignment. Maybe my husband can help me with that. Wheel alignment,
yeah?
And they are aligned so that every wheel can be in its position. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And when every wheel is in its position, then the car will move the right way.
Amen.
It is time for the Lord to align the church. There are people who are not called even to be praise and worship, but they are here singing off key. Because they have not been aligned, they have not even known which is their position. There are others who are calling themselves big names, chief apostle, right reverend, or left. Eventually they will be nameless because they have taken all the titles. There are others who are saying, I'm an intercessor. Yet that is not their position. Why is there so much friction in the church? It is because people are in the wrong place.
Amen.
People are in the wrong positions. You want to be a pastor, yet you can't even love those who backbite you. You want to be an usher, yet you cannot even clean a mess after a deliverance service. You are Mama Kanisa, and that is what you want, yet you are the one who makes sure that the youths get lost in church. Akikuja tu amevaa fani, Mama Kanisa ni anamaliza. Tell your neighbor divine positioning.
Divine position.
It is time that we become aligned in our position. Because once everyone is in their position, and another thing, when the wheels are aligned, they are not aligned to work solo. Hello? They don't work alone, like this wheel alone, the other one alone. They are aligned so that they work together.
Right, that's right.
When there is going to be divine alignment, the Sunday school teacher will be able to work together with the usher. The usher will be able to work with the pastor. the pastor will be able to work with the intercessor, because it is not about you alone. It is teamwork.
Amen.
And that is why the Bible says that we are the body of Christ.
Amen.
Assuming the hand will do the work of the mouth, there will be total confusion. And that is what is happening in the body of Christ. Tell your neighbor, divine positioning. And ask your neighbor, who are you? Hallelujah. Akorwo mundu ne kugurure kietikire guthie. Akorwo mundu ne kanwa tangire kietikire kwaria. For those who did not understand that Spanish, I'm saying if you are a mouth, use it. Talk. Praise the name of the Lord. If you are the legs, walk. Go. Take the gospel. But let us not remain in friction because we are in the wrong place. If Joseph remained in Shechem, he could not have started his journey to become a prime minister. He could have given up and gone home, and that would be the end of his dreams. But he still waited until he was divinely connected to the right place.
Amen. That's right.
It doesn't matter, even if there seems to be nothing happening, but are you in the right place? I would rather be in the right place. No matter how much time it takes, praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And so as I come to a close, I want to connect these things. That when you receive the promise, you should receive it by faith.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When you receive the promise, you should receive it by faith.
Amen.
Because one thing I know is that our God is a promise maker.
Yes, He is.
Nobody walked with God unless they made a promise. They made a covenant. From Abraham all the way down, our God is a promise maker. It doesn't matter how He promised you, whether in dreams or you had a voice or somebody told you or you just get inspired, but our God is a promise maker. And our God is a promise keeper.
Amen.
He keeps His promises. So with the promises that you have, you better embrace the promises by faith. Knowing so well that whoever promised shall come to fulfill it.
Amen.
I remember when I got born again at the age of 9. And at a very young age, one man of God spoke over my life and said, God is going to make you an international speaker. And I remember it was in a meeting and he called my parents and he told my parents, take care of this girl because she'll become an international
speaker.
And let me tell you, sometimes those promises are so far from reality by the time you hear them. Praise the name of the Lord. But one thing I have come to realize, there is nothing as important as being divinely positioned. Because it doesn't matter how long the promises take. As long as you're in the right position, our God, who is the promise maker, is the promise keeper.
Right.
He shall keep it.
Right.
And now when we come to positioning, I want you to mark this. In promise, remember faith. In positioning, remain focused. Some people are positioned. And some places that we are positioned, there are so many things that can tempt us. There are so many things that can divert us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every positioning of Joseph's life was great. At Potiphar's house, he became the chief of the servants. He could have remained there. And life was good. Amen.
Amen.
In prison, he became the chief of the prisoners. He could have remained there. After all, siyo hata hiyo ni ukubwa. Si hata hiyo ni heshima. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
But in every divine positioning, remain focused. Do not be diverted by what is around you. Do not be diverted by the people around you. So many people have moved from the places that God wants them to be because of people. Let me speak that because I feel the Spirit of the Lord telling me to speak about it. People have been mispositioned because of people. Watu walisema, watu waliona, watu walisikia. And because of people, you move from your position. So that they stop talking. So that they stop saying. So that they stop thinking. In divine positioning, I have come to tell you, remain focused.
Amen.
You can say that it doesn't matter how much they talk. It doesn't matter what comes my way, but I am focused. There is what I'm watching. There is where I am going. I will not be diverted.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And even in the church, because I said I'm talking about personal and also the church has been diverted. We have brought the world in the church. And the Bible says that do not be conformed to the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. But what have we done? We have brought everything worldly in the church. And when we have the music instruments, we think that's the presence of God. Kinanda ikigongo vizuri unafikiria Yesu amekuja. We have lost the sense of discerning when the Lord is there. When somebody comes and speaks so eloquently, you think that there is God. We have lost the sense of hearing the presence of God and seeing the manifestation of God. You come to church empty, you go out empty, and you think it's okay. In divine positioning, remain focused. And finally, in the fulfillment of the purpose of God over your life, fear the Lord.
Amen.
Fear the Lord. Because whatever God has promised, I'm telling you for sure He's faithful. He will surely fulfill it. And in your journey, as you continue to walk, He will continue manifesting Himself. But what shall govern you is the fear of the Lord. Because in the fear of the Lord comes wisdom. In the fear of the Lord comes knowledge. In the fear of the Lord comes wealth and honor.
Amen.
But some of us, they received the promise. Maybe your promise was coming to America. And now you're here. Then what? You get a phone call from home and you're there saying, I don't see me see that you go to Tuagabesha Mitene. Material don't get more. Because you are thinking you are very special, yeah? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I don't know which is your promise that has been fulfilled, but even in the fulfillment of the purposes of God over your life, let us abide in the fear of the Lord. Because the fear of the Lord is what is going to continue elevating you. The more you fear the Lord, the more you reverence the Lord, the more He takes you to the next level. There are some people who never go beyond the first promise because when they made it, they thought it was their strength. When they made it, they could not let anybody else talk. You are all bragging and shoulders high, thinking you made it by your power. In the fulfillment of the promises of God, let us fear the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I don't want to continue so much, but I hope you get that the promise, receive it by faith. In the divine position, remain focused. In the fulfillment of the purposes of God, fear the Lord.
Amen.
And with that, we shall be victorious.
Amen.
With that, we shall receive whatever God has purposed for us.
Amen.
Let's stand on our feet. The presence of the Lord. Amen. I declare the blessings of God over your life. May the Lord shine upon you. May the peace of God walk with you. Blessed be your coming out and your going in. May you be the head and not the tail. May you expand on all corners. You are blessed and not cast. You are blessed and not cast. And no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper in the name of Jesus. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.